For me, there is nothing more rewarding than seeing this iconic and majestic bird in the wild. But with only 440 pairs scattered over the whole of Scotland, they have to be one of the country's most elusive creatures. I've set myself a challenge. I've got less than 48 hours to find and film a golden eagle. But I've got a promising tip-off. Eagle expert Roy Dennis has satellite-tagged eagles in this part of the Cairngorms and says that right now there could be at least four eagles within striking distance.
So with conditions like this, how difficult is it going to be?
You know, sometimes I walk up here, I drive up here, and I see two or three immediately. And other days I never see any. So at present time, this is very much a kind of nursery or learning area for eagles, because you're getting a succession of immature and juvenile eagles here.
So it's amazing, you've got young birds coming here and really honing their skills on these hills.
Yeah, a lot of it is learning how to live. A bit like what you're going to do today, is learning how to get across these bogs.
Even though several juveniles use this area, they can range over hundreds of miles, so they're not going to be easy to find.
This wind is quite incredible. This backpack acts like a sail, so the wind just pushes you all over the mountaintop.
This is big country, inhospitable to man and accessible to only the hardiest creatures. After a few hours of hard slog, I find proof that there are young eagles in the area.
There we go. Oh, got it. Now this is feather from a golden eagle. It might not look like a golden eagle feather. That's because it's a downy feather from a juvenile. Oh, look at this. We have a pellet. And I would say, at that sort of size, this is from a golden eagle.
Like other raptors, golden eagles regurgitate a pellet full of hair and bones that they can't digest. This one is full of the fur of mountain hare. After several more hours of being battered about, I see another encouraging sign and find myself face to face with the eagle's favourite food, already in its white winter coat.
A mountain hare, just hidden down there. His ears are still a little bit brown. Now you can imagine a golden eagle soaring over this hilltop and seeing a white hare running across the hilltop. It just makes for a really easy target. Oh, there he goes.
A disappointing day. No eagles. They'll be looking for some place to rest up for the night. For me, this bothy offers shelter and somewhere to recharge my batteries for another day. A new day begins and there's something positive on the horizon.
We've got a couple of ravens up there, which is a good sign. Ravens and golden eagles quite closely associate. They feed on carrion that's found up on the hill, and at this time of year in the winter there's lots of dead animals that have met their demise up on the hilltops.
I set off again. The going seems tougher today, and with every step I become more and more disheartened. I'm finding it hard to keep my spirits up, and I spend the rest of the day without a single sighting of an eagle. There's only an hour left before I'm due to leave this mountain. Once the light goes, my time is up. Then, in the gloom, I catch a glimpse of something.
Hang on. There we go, we have an eagle. Yay! Let's try and stay on it. Wonderful. Okay, it's just stopped on a rock there. How about that? Okay. It is. Whoa! Great. Now, it's very distant. We're about to lose the sun. A glimpse like this is all the reward that I really need. They are the ultimate emblem of nature in this country, the ultimate symbol of the wild.